find our way to the control center from here.
Good luck. Bullhammer out.
We shouldn't even have guards stationed here. Like, what purpose is there to have guards stationed here, other than for this exact occasion? Clearly, that was not the last thing they were expecting, Cortana. Okay. So, assault on the control room. It's actually a level I don't like. Let me turn on my headphones real fast. Okay. Alright, I honestly don't like assault on the control room, because it's a really difficult, really tedious, really long level. And a lot of people like it because there's a certain part in the level that lets you drive a tank. Yeah, we're going to be driving a tank at this level. And I honestly don't like that part either. But apparently I don't like to have fun.
The weather patterns here seem natural, not artificial. I wonder if the ring's environment systems are malfunctioning. Or if the designers wanted the installation to have inclement weather.
This is Fireteam Zuna requesting immediate assistance from any UNSC forces. Does anyone copy? Over.
I didn't think there were any human forces left on this part of the ring.
Cortana to Fireteam Zulu. I read you. Fireteam Zulu, this is Cortana. Hold position. We're on our way.
Roger that. Make it quick.
Yeah, I'm kind of a bit rusty. This is the first practice run of this level I've had in a few months. No, I mean, this is an actual run. I had a practice run before this, like right before this, just to get me warmed up, but it's still not enough. Dang it. But yeah, about the fun thing, apparently I'm the only guy in the universe who doesn't like sailing in Assassin's Creed games, so go figure how I won't like the tank in this game. I used to like it, but now I don't. Yeah, but just be prepared to be strapped in for a while. If you're curious by the video length, because there's like a really long cutscene, no, there's not a really long cutscene. It's because this level is just that long. This is a really long level. This level probably takes about like 40 minutes to complete. At least that's how long it took me in my practice run right before this. So I pretty much just skip the enemies in these rooms, because there are a lot of these rooms. There are a lot of these rooms with a lot of enemies in them. It's not worth killing them all. Now let's see what I got here. I should probably pick up a plasma pistol, unless there's a new plasma rifle. Yep, there it is. I don't even remember how many of these rooms there are, but there are a lot of them. There are a lot of bridges, like the one we just passed. And there are a lot of these elevators here. Or, as the game likes to call them, lifts. Even though they descend. All of them descend. I mean, I suppose they could ascend to somewhere, but where would you go? Where would you go that would require you to go up in this place? Up to that cliff? Where you can only intercept soldiers? That fly aircraft through a tunnel? Because everybody thinks of that, right? Damn it. I wish I could have recorded the practice session, because I snuck by him very winningly. It was like Metal Gear Solid status. Yeah, because I'm still kind of cold from lack of playing. I'm sticking with the plasma rifle instead of the plasma pistol, even though the plasma pistol is much more effective. but I don't want to put forth the effort to make it more effective. And then there's this outside area. This is pretty much why the whole level is long, actually, now that I think about it. Now, I usually don't favor taking the rocket launcher during this part, but because people like to see explosions, I'm going to go ahead and go with it. Make a good showcase of the rocket launcher anyhow. If any of the Marines want to come in here, that's kind of an important thing about driving a Warthog around. You kind of need a gunner. And then we could just screw the rest of the Marines here. They'll be okay. I mean, they won't, but yeah. Also, there's ice in this game. And as you can see, there are ice physics. And they apply to every vehicle in this game, even ghosts. There are ice physics, and you will slip on ghosts, even though ghosts are aircraft. Or not aircraft, they're hovercrafts. So, yeah. Oh man. Ice physics in this game. And Marines getting in my fucking way. Yeah, sometimes the Wraith back there follows you over here, and sometimes it doesn't. Oh, there it is. I just saw it go over the whole over the hill. And it is destroyed. And here we have the tank. Fits 4 passengers. It has a machine gun turret, as well as a main cannon. It controls really awkwardly. So instead of just plowing through everything, we're going to have to actually play defensively with the tank, because it is quite vulnerable to other tanks here, and lots of other things.
Hey, they got armor support! Watch out for those tanks!
The Covenant placed their tanks to defend the tunnel.
There's usually another turret right there, but I guess it didn't spawn for some reason. And sometimes where the main cannon fires just doesn't make any sense. Just like the machine gun turret. The machine gun doesn't make a buttload of sense, but you can get a general idea. You can't get a precise shot. I wasn't trying to get them killed. I kind of like to have Marines on this tank, but what can you do? Yeah, usually the impact point for the main cannon is like in between the bottom of the reticle and those two arrows. Which is very weird. Oh, by the way, I got a Banshee shooting at me. Banshees with their plasma cannons. They also have fuel rod cannons, like those hunters over there have. Which will deal shit ton of damage. They're no match for us. You can't drive Wraiths in this game, in case you were wondering. Unless you play the PC version and do a hack for it, but it's like... If I start saying that about everything that you can't do in this game, then everything will be suffixed with that. Suffix was the wrong word for it, but you get what I mean.
Get
playing a game and talking at the same time, so. You will find that I will say the wrong things sometimes. And I don't have the patience to fix it in post-commentary for this level. I've already spent enough time with this level, as it stands! Because I must have done so many practice runs for this level. Because every few weeks, it's like, I go in to this level and I do a practice run of it, and then I end up not LPing. But then by the time I do get in the mood to LP this level, I'm not warmed up to it, and I have to do a practice run to warm up to it. So I must have played this level probably 30 times within the past, like, maybe 2 months. So I'm not exactly fond of it, especially since I already don't like the level. Out for plasma grenades. I didn't even know where that one went. I thought it went over there, but apparently it didn't. But what was I supposed to do? What was I supposed to do there? Just, like, you can only get stuck by that freaking grunt. It's like I didn't have time to react to that. They were both still alive. Now, you can go into the structure and kill a bunch of invisible elites to get active camouflage, but why would you want to do that? I don't know. It's like, oh hey, let's get the active camouflage and then start driving a vehicle. If I get active camouflage, my vehicle will be invisible too, right? No. It'll only last for 45 seconds anyway, and it's like 45 seconds is nothing in an area this big. It's nothing. Okay, I actually have to start moving around here because otherwise that wraith will kill me. I missed completely. Ah, fuck. I don't know if you heard me facepalming there, but I was just like, man, why did I do that? I got caught on the ice, that's why I went with it. I was just like, well, shit, I'm stuck on ice now. Looks like I'll just have to charge! Now, a lot of people think that the tank is faster. At least a lot of Halo players I know think that the tank is faster in this game than it is in Halo 2, when it really isn't. It looks like it's faster, but it's not. I guess it's just the way players move in the game and the angle of the camera that just make it think like it's moving slower. a little weird. My tank play is absolute garbage. See if I can hit this. Yep, there we go.
I thought the Covenant had eliminated all the Marine forces in this area.
There we go. Nice dead hunters. Wait, but they drop off. I can't even see the enemies. Well, when you have Marines and you only have a sniper rifle and a rocket launcher, this is actually why I don't like taking the rocket launcher, because I'd rather have the sniper rifle. And this active camouflage actually comes in real handy for this guy right here. He normally doesn't face that direction. I don't know why he was, but he was. But having a rocket launcher here isn't a bad idea.
Looks like the Covenant is ducking up there. We're totally hemmed in.
We need to get up this ridge.
Marines, hold your positions. We'll handle those guns.
Master Chief, we should scan the ridge and get below those stationary guns.
Affirmative, holding position.
There's a good reason to have the rocket launcher here, too. Because that, and because that, and because that! I'd honestly rather have a pistol for those. Pistols are still really effective for taking out vehicles, but since this level gives you a rocket launcher and a lot of ammo for it, I might as well take the ample opportunity to make some explosions and just do that. Just make explosions. Because explosions entertain people, right? Is that still the stigma I'm going with? Maybe. All right. This part of the level didn't go too bad as it normally does. As bad as it normally does, I mean. And these Marines are just going to stay out here and guard the building from nothing. Ignore all the audio that comes from sleeping grunts after you kill them, because they don't register as anything to anybody, unless of course you wake them up. Fuck you guys. Oh, man. That's not what I want to do either. Okay. Yep. I don't even want to fight you guys. It's not worth fighting you guys. You guys can fuck off and die. Oh, never mind. This one ascends. My bad. Oh no, there's an enemy. I didn't see that coming. Probably should have used the rocket launcher. Rocket launcher's melee attack is just better. Actually, no, it does the same amount of strength. Never mind. Same amount of damage. Okay. Alright, let's try this again. That rocket launcher is more trouble than it's worth. It's more appropriate when you played this level co-op so that one of you can hold on to the rocket launcher. You don't need to over-encumber yourself with both the rocket launcher and the sniper rifle. I normally don't like to do that. Okay, so there are grunts over there that are sleeping that won't wake up and start shooting at you if you don't get caught, which I just did. Whoops. Do it while the shields are down. Take the risk. There's an invisible guy. Right there. I saw him clear as day. What? Why are you all corralled over here? You're normally not. Normally. Whoops, I got caught. In a shooter game. I could pick up that plasma rifle, but I feel like sticking with this. I can stick with this. Oh, wait. Thank you for health. Yes! Hoorah! I found a pistol. At least they have arrows here to tell you, hey, this is where you need to go, so that in case you don't get lost. Oh, God damn it. You were not supposed to see me. Thank you. I drive myself crazy trying to fight every single enemy in this damn place. Okay, so I'm camping over here because of that. These guys. Also, explosions can sometimes go through glass and can go through cover, so if you're standing too close to it, you'll get caught into it. Which isn't nice at all. Get a good shot on this guy. That guy, I will not be so fortunate with. Because he will constantly be looking at me, unless I can get lucky. I got lucky and I blew it. And I somehow did not get hit there. You know, in the Flood novel, they actually note how easy it is to kill a hunter with a pistol. There we go. Now this part won't be so bad. Sometimes people run out of rocket ammo or don't take the sniper with them and end up having to do this part with the hunters constantly shooting at them. Which isn't fun. I actually didn't notice that before. That glass is not breakable. I'm just like, oh hey, that's an interesting point. So I was looking at it and I was thinking, wait, what would happen if the glass breaks here? It's like I fall into a bottomless pit and die. But nope, they thought about that one. They didn't think about it in the tank room, but obviously, you're not going to be on foot and be able to fall through them while in the tank. I'm already running out of ammo for this. That sucks. I think there's another ammo stash in this room. Nope, not in this one. Oh, I guess I could have done this all along. I could have just cut through the middle and get to where I needed to be instead of just going all the way around, but I wasn't doing that because I forgot that that was an option. One down, two down. I think there is a third one. And he has a sword. Maybe I'm thinking of a higher difficulty, because he didn't appear. Okay. Oh, great. Hunters. And they just... Oh, yeah. I remember on my practice file, or my practice run before this, that they just know where you are. Oh, whoop. Take damage to kill. You gotta take damage to save time. I don't want the fucking rocket. Fine. Okay.
This must be the control room. Subtle. The entrance to the control center is at the top of that pyramid structure. Bring me up there, I should be able to get us inside.
There's actually a shortcut you can take here involving that Banshee. You can fly over there, which is where you need to go, into that pyramid structure. But, for the sake of the LP, I am going to suffer through the badness that is the long parts of the level. Please, don't let your weapon fly off. Your weapon flew off! I mean, I was using a rocket launcher, so it's to be expected, but yeah, one can only hope, you know? You know what, I'll actually show off the Needler a little bit. I personally don't like to use it. I don't think it's very good. Not in this game. Basically, if you land enough needles in an enemy, it blows them up and kills them almost instantly, like a plasma grenade. But like I said, I personally don't like it because it's kind of ineffective. It doesn't work too well on enemies that dodge side to side, which is every enemy in this game. It has a cool looking melee attack, though. Not that it does any more damage or anything. Chief Solid. I actually heard that Master Chief was going to be a character in that new Kojima game.
The entrance to the control center is located at the top of the We should commandeer one of those ghosts. We're going to need the firepower.
Yeah, screw that. We don't need the ghosts. Because you only need the ghosts to fight that thing. Trying to get up here with the ghost is like, no, don't even try it. I mean, honestly, it does make the trek up the pyramid easier. Without the rain shooting at you, but it's a little bit more trouble than I'm prepared to handle at the moment. Don't get in these turrets at all. Almost there. Almost there. The home stretch. I'm finally done with this god-awful level. I hate this level so much, I hate it. I didn't kill that... I'm pretty sure I killed that Banshee when I was back on that bridge. Evidently, I did not. Ah, jeez, I missed the hunters coming down that ramp there. I almost died. Oh, fuck! What? Oh, God. And I have to kill that Banshee again. The grunt shows up. The hunters escaped. Okay, I don't know how I didn't hit that grunt there. You motherfucker. Oh, I'm dead. Oh, never mind. I thought I was gonna take fall damage from that. There we go. Well, I believe I'm at the 40-minute mark for this recording. And you could go up this ramp, but there's nothing up there. No weapons, nothing. So, we're gonna open this door, then we're gonna run away like a bitch. Ha, General Elite. More like General of Running Like a Bitch. And his back turned in the face of an enemy. That's not the way of the samurai. Last one. And the level is complete. Thank God. That's a good thing, because that pretty much means the rest of the game is really good.
Covenant forces in the vicinity have been eliminated. Let's move on to Halo's control center. Halo's control center. Try there.
You all right?
Never been better. You can't imagine the wealth of information. The knowledge, so much, so fast. It's glorious.
So, what sort of weapon is it?
What are you talking about?
Let's stay focused. Halo, how do we use it against the Covenant?
This ring isn't a cudgel, you barbarian. It's something else. Something much more important. The Covenant were right. This ring... it's Forerunner. Give me a second to access. Yes, the Forerunner built this place, what they called a fortress world, in order to... Wait. No, that can't be. Oh, those Covenant fools. They must have known. There must have been signs.
Slow down. You're losing me.
The Covenant found something. Buried in this ring. Something horrible. And now, they're afraid.
Something buried? Wait.
The Captain. We've got to stop the Captain.
Keys?
What the weapons cache he's looking for. It's not really... We can't let him get inside.
I don't understand.
There's no time. Get out of here, find Keys, stop him. Before it's too late!